Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Assalamu alaikum. Today we'll discuss the topic that is from the program Fundamental of Programming. The topic of our discussion is urinary operators. The outline of our topic that we are going to discuss today is what is an operator, operators in C++, assignment operators, arithmetic operators, relational operators, logical operators, types of logical operators. Next, we have syntax of operators, and at the end, summary. So, what are operators? Operators are the symbol which perform operations on operand. The operation may be arithmetic or comparisons of data. That is, for example, we have z is equal to x plus y. The z is equal to x plus y is a statement in which we are just having a look that an operator, that is arithmetic operator plus is used in it, an assignment operator equal is used in it. So here x and y and z are operands and plus and equals are operators. C++ is a rich in operators and supports a wide range of these operators that range simplest unary to the complex ternary. Operators are very important because without their use, expressions cannot be evaluated. Operators in C++, we have arithmetic operators, assignment operators, bitwise, shift operators, unary operators, ternary operators, comma, relational operators, logical and at the end mathematical operators. Next we have types. The following are the three different types of operators in C++: arithmetic operators, assignment operators, compound or arithmetic operators. The next we have increment and decrement operators. Next we have prefix and postfix forms, relational operators, logic operators, which is also called logical operators, unary, binary and ternary operators. Assignment operator program, that is include iostream, include conio.h, main function, int variable a, variable b, that is declaration of variable. Next we have assignment of variables 100 and 400 values, simply cout of variable a, and l, line end, and cout of variable b, get sketch and return 0. Next we have assignment operators. An assignment operator is a mathematical function that takes two operands and perform a mathematical calculation on them. They are used in common arithmetic, and most computer languages contain a set of such operators that can be used within equations to perform a number of types of sequential calculation. For example, here we are operating these operators, like if we are declaring and assigning the values to x and y, x equal to 2 and y equal to 10. Now you can see that x plus and equal 4, the comment line is telling us that x now contains 6. How this x now contains 6? Look, if this x, which is 2, we have assigned the value of 2 to x, so if this x, that is 2, adds with the 4, then we'll get, then equal them, 2 plus 4 is equal to 6, and same as so on. Next we have arithmetic operation equality, that is addition assignment operator, subtraction assignment operator, multiplication assignment operator. Next we will call them division assignment operator and remainder assignment operators. Similarly, a plus equal to 1 is same as a is equal to a plus 1. A plus equal, we are just changing the position of that arithmetic operators. That is, if we use to write like a plus equal to 1, or we can also write it as a equal to a plus 1. Here we are just writing a once, and we are operating the operators in a sequential order, and here we are again using the a, that is a is equal to a plus 1. Okay, a minus equal to 1 is same as a is equal to a minus 1. A multiply equal to 1 is same as a is equal to a multiply 1. Now I hope you are getting this. A divide equal to 1 is same as a is equal to a divided by 1. Similarly, so on. Increment and decrement. As the name shows, increment is increasing something and decrement is decreasing something. C programming has two operators, increment, that is plus plus, and decrement, we use to show them like minus minus, to change the value of an operand, constant or variable by 1. So the plus plus will increment the value by 1 and the minus minus will decrement the value by 1. Okay, you can say that increment plus plus increases the value by 1, whereas decrement decreases the value by 1. These two operators are unary operators, meaning that they only operate on a single operand. Unary operators, why we call them unary operators? Because it means that they only operate on single operand, okay, not two or multiple operands. We use the assignment operator increment and decrement only on single operand. Assignment operator increment, that is increment operator plus plus, and operator as prefix and postfix. We can use this operator as prefix and postfix. Prefix means we'll write is in the preposition, and postfix means we'll write in the postposition, like after that statement. If you use the plus plus operator as prefix, like plus plus variable, we have write this plus plus operator before the value, before the variable, then it will call prefix. Pre mean before, prefix before the position. So the plus plus variable is prefix, and the value of variable is incremented by 1, then it returns the value. So here is the difference in functions too. The syntax and the functions too is differentiated by using the increment or decrement variable as postfix and prefix. If we'll use this operator as prefix, then the value of variable is incremented by 1 first, and then it will return the value, okay? And if we use the operator plus plus as postfix, post mean after the variable, that is variable plus plus, the original value of the variable is returned first, then the variable is incremented by 1. I hope you are getting this point. Just again revise it, that if you use the operator before the position, then the variable will be incremented by 1 first. Firstly, the value of the variable will be incremented by 1, and then it will return the value. And in the second, when we will use it as a postfix, the original value of the variable is returned in first as it is, and then the variable is incremented by 1. If we use the operator plus plus as the postfix, like variable plus plus, the original value of the variable is returned first and the variable is incremented by 1, the again system is returned as. Now we'll call about negative, that is decrement operator works in the similar way like the increment operator, except it decreases the value by 1. The whole use before the position, that is prefix and postfix, the whole process is just like same, but it is differentiated by this function, that decrement operator will decrease the value by 1 and increment operator will increase the value by 1. Plus equal addition assignment operator, okay, it is also known as increment operator syntax. Variable plus equal to value, variable is equal to variable plus 1, as we have discussed in the previous slides, that is a plus equal to 1 will be equal to a equal to a plus 1. Similarly, here you can see that variable plus equal to value, variable equal to variable plus value. Okay, so we can also say it as increment operator because it is increasing the value of variable. First we have variable, then it will increase the value of variable by adding this value, so that is why it is called as increment operator. Hope you are getting this. Decrement operator, negative equals subtraction. Assignment operator is also known as decrement operator syntax. Variable equal to minus equal to variable is equal to variable minus value. The value will be subtracted from the variable, then we will get the original value of the variable. So it will decrement or decrease the value by 1. Relational operators. In computer science, a relational operator is a programming language construct or operator that tests or defines some kinds of relational relations between two entities. These includes numerical equality, for example 5 equal to 5, and inequalities, for example 4 is greater or equal to 3. So relational operators will basically relate the values, for example 5 is equal to 5, that is true, and 4, we can say that 4 is greater than 3, that is true, or we can say 4 is greater or equal than 3. So basically we are relating these values, so we use these operator, we name these operators as relational operators. Next we have logical operators. A logical operator is a symbol or a word used to connect two or more expressions such that the value of the compound expressions produced depends only on that of the original expression and on the meaning of the operator. Common logical operators include AND, OR, and NOT. I hope you know what the AND operator do, what the OR operator do, what the NOT operator do. These AND, OR, and NOT operators, we also draw some truth table. You guys say truth table. Basically, they are called truth tables. We use different truth tables for understanding the usage of these operators AND, OR, and NOT. Types of logical operator. Number 1, logical NOT, logical AND, and logical OR. Unary operators. Unary operators. Unary operators in C++, it operates on a pointer variable and returns an value equivalent to the value at the pointer address, that is called dereferencing the pointer. Dereferencing and dereferencing. Understood this pronunciation? That is dereferencing. Referencing is means to refer someone, refer something, and dereferencing is the opposite of refer. So the result of the unary plus operator is the value of its operand. For example, x is equal to negative y, a is equal to plus b. Binary operators. What are binary operators? Binary operators are those operators that work on two operands, as the name show, binary. So bi mean two. Binary operator means the binary operators are those operators that work with the two operands. So we can say that, for example, a common binary expression would be a plus b, the addition operator, plus surrounded by two operands. The binary operators are further subdivided into arithmetic, relational operators, logical, or assignment operators. There are three types of binary operators, that is mathematical operators, logical operators in which we use logics, in mathematics we simply do mathematical calculations. Next we have relational, in which we relate. There are four basic mathematical operations, that is addition, subtraction, multiplication, and division. Next we have ternary operators. The ternary operators is an operators that take three arguments. The first argument is a comparison argument, the second is the result upon a true comparison, and the third one is the result upon the false comparison. For example, experimenting. An expression is a formula in which operands are linked to each other by the use of operators to compute a value. An operand can be function, reference, a variable, an array, an element, or a constant. An expression is a combination of one or more operands, zero or more operands, or zero or more pairs of parentheses. Following kinds of expressions are: an arithmetic operation evaluates to a single arithmetic value. A logical or relational expression evaluates to a single logical value. Next, we have procedure operators. Operators procedures determine the grouping of the terms in an expression and decides how an expression is evaluated. Certain operators have higher procedures precedence than others. For example, the multiplication operator has a higher precedence than the additional operators. Unary operators overloading in C++ programming language. Overloading unary operator. Let us consider to overload negative unary operators. In unary operators, no argument should be passed as they are unary operators. Overloading unary operator. Let us consider to overload negative unary operators. In unary operators function, no argument should be passed. It works only with one class object. It is a overloading of the operator operating on a single operand. Now, what is the syntax of unary operators overloading in C++? The operator overloading is a type of polymorphism in which an operator is overloaded to give user defined meaning to it. It is used to perform operation on user defined data type. For example, following programs is overloading unary operators increment and decrement. So this was our today's lecture. In the next lecture, we'll discuss the overloading and overwriting. Hope you'll get this lecture, and if you have any queries, you can ask in comments below, and I want you guys to write the summary in the comments below that what you have learned from this lecture. We'll meet you in the next lecture. Till then, Allah Hafiz.